This is Taylor Swift's Good House in Town Thanksgiving special. Actually, this is just the entire special. I mean, I could
We're actually gonna sit here for all 42 minutes.
Yeah. Oh, see, that's a good song. Oh, I got it. Okay, I brought our champagne, everyone.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, dude, so I don't know if anybody's in the mood for
Let's open it.
Champagne. Is it going to pop? How do you pop it?
Woo!
Uh-oh.
Just a few.
Oh man, these are
wow!
It's like the New Year, the New Year's, everybody.
This is high class.
Cool. Well,
ding,
ding.
I mean, I'll start by saying I recognize this is like a good movie. It's not really the type of movie. I'm not really a buddy comedy type of gal.
It's like a fun,
but it's like. It's the type of movie I would put on in the background. You know, like there's nothing terrible that's in it. This is the perfect movie to play while everyone's in the kitchen making Thanksgiving.
Yeah, it's like a fun movie. Yeah. It's like a good time, you know. It's and there's not many Thanksgiving movies out there. This is just legitimately about Thanksgiving.
I think it's weird there aren't more like romantic Thanksgiving movies.
Yeah, you know, it's
I guess it's just a timing thing. Everything, all the Christmas ones come out.
So close to Christmas and whatnot. So we can look up Thanksgiving movies. Yeah, no one's heard of Holiday. Oh, actually, I always wanted to see Free Birds. That's where they go back in time to stop to stop Thanksgiving for that. Oh, actually, that is true. The Addams Family Values is actually a Thanksgiving movie. It has Thanksgiving in it, I think.
Football just makes
their
it
family.
A Thanksgiving movie.
I guess Miracle on 34th Street starts at Thanksgiving. Scent of a Woman. Oh, dude, great film. Yeah, anyway.
Adam's Family Values.
You know, it has like a Thanksgiving skit. And actually, look it up, Grant. They have a really good Thanksgiving song in Adam's Family Values. It's actually not too bad. But anyway, it's a good Thanksgiving film. It's like, you know, good, feel good. Hey, we're happy, you know? So,
we're happy. Do you like Thanksgiving a lot as a holiday?
It's all right.
Yeah.
I probably like Christmas more, I guess.
I will say that I think Friendsgiving has gotten out of control.
Oh, yeah. I don't even really. Okay. This is the Addams Family song. Yeah. It's really. Do you do a lot of Friendsgivings?
I will go to a Friendsgiving and have an amazing time. I think it's just gotten out of control for people because it used to be like. This is not to knock the Friendsgivings I've attended, but it used to be like Friendsgiving. I felt like it's like, oh, that's just what we call Thanksgiving with our friends if we can't go home.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Or you can go home.
But so it's like have it on Thanksgiving for people who can't go home or don't want to go home or whatever. But now it's like a separate thing that takes place like
It's
the
like
week
a whole,
before Thanksgiving.
It's a whole holiday now.
Like, it's a lot, right?
Like, it kind of brings, I haven't been to many Friendsgivings.
And I mean, it's like one of the things where it's like, if you want to do all that, cool. But it's like, there's some people who are like, oh yeah, I've got like three Friendsgivings
I've heard that
this
before.
Weekend. And it's like, good Lord, like who? It's crazy.
Yeah, only been like one. I didn't even bring anything. Okay. That was awkward for instance.
Yeah. The one I went to one that was awesome, but yeah. It's just like there are people who talk to me and they're like, oh yeah, I have to hit all the Friendsgivings.
That's true.
And it's like, that's so crazy.
Yeah, I don't like you guys that much to have that many Thanksgivings.
I honestly don't really like turkey enough.
Dude, honestly, I feel the same. I've said that before.
Like, it's already enough that I'm eating it. You know?
Like it can be good sometimes, but most of the time it's pretty bad.
I'm more the dark meat guy. I'm all about the dark meat.
I think we might not be doing turkey this year in my family. I'm not sure. I suggested that we not because... And my mom seemed to be into it. She was like, yeah, if like people like something else better. I was like, why don't we all have steak? Like,
oh, that's awesome.
That's cool.
So I don't know if we're doing that.
Yeah, I don't think Roland would fly with that. I don't think.
What?
I don't think my mom would fly with that.
Yeah.
I think she's like, tradition.
Yeah, well, my mom was like, what? I mean, I got, like, we've stopped doing turkey at Christmas, so.
Yeah, I think
they do beef roast.
We have, like, we have, like, ham for Christmas.
Yeah.
Yeah, so.
But anyway. Yeah, it's just like not my favorite.
Yeah, it's. I mean, yeah, it's. I don't like turkey that much. To be,
it's a lot too. If like, it, like for my family now at Thanksgiving, it's just like my immediate family. Like that's a lot of meat for like a few people, and I don't want to eat turkey sandwiches for like.
Well, my mom puts in like a casserole and whatnot, so she uses this for other stuff. But yeah, usually it's going to be me and my parents, and maybe my sister might stop by with her family. But she got two families, so usually it's me chilling with Ryan and Keith, everyone. It was Keith's birthday yesterday. So,
happy birthday, Keith.
Yeah. And a couple weeks for Answer Diary, everyone. So big things happening with my parents.
Hell yeah.
Yeah. So.
What's your favorite Thanksgiving dish?
I like stuffing a lot.
Stuffing. Yeah.
Stuffing's good. I like stuffing.
Stuffing.
Yeah. You like stuffing?
I like tomato aspic a lot. It's a southern thing. Yeah.
What's that?
It's like tomato and then like cream cheese and vegetables like mixed together. It's a southern thing. It's like they have it in Georgia a lot, but like they've made it like my grandma used to make it and my mom makes it every year. Yeah. It's like like a thing for Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
But cool. And like sweet potato.
Yeah, yams.
Mac and cheese.
Yeah, mac and cheese is good.
My mom pickles, so she gets out all the pickles, and then there's like the pickles.
Pickles.
Yeah, she makes pickles.
Okay, I didn't know she was pickling other stuff.
Yes, she does pickled okra, pickled peaches, and then bread and butter pickles. So you got to put the pickles out, and that's really good. Yeah.
Yeah, they can be. Yeah, my brother-in-law makes pickles. They can be kind of. Sour. I mean, the vinegar, so if you don't do it long enough.
I was stoned as fuck the other night, and I was like, man, pickled okra would hit right now. And then I went and I opened my jar that my mom gave me.
Oh,
and
dang,
I was like, hell yeah.
That is perfect timing.
It was really good.
Yeah,
it was
I will say that's not my go-to.
No, I was having my dairy-free ice cream, and then I was like, you know what? It hit some pickled okra.
All right. Anyway, we found that Adam's Family song about Thanksgiving.
Yeah, it's this is way different. That's a weird transition. Okay.
Well, anyway, you know, cool. But yeah, it's a classic movie here. Steve Martin, John Candy, and they're both trying to make it home for Thanksgiving.
Yeah, it's always fun to watch these, like, nostalgic, like, 80s movies because it's, like, I feel like the 80s really weren't that long ago.
Yeah.
But there's so many things that are different, like, not having the cell phones readily available, not having, like, GPS, like, having to use maps, like,
Is this the whole movie? Oh, yeah, I thought you found out the entire movie.
I was about to say, I paid $3.99 to rent it.
Oh, dude, you can, it's free on Pluto TV. It's like, Pluto TV is like free kind of cable. It's like, it has like advertisements, but they have like a bunch of channels. But just let you guys know about Pluto TV. Anyway, and it starts with, dude, Steve Martin has to get to the airport to make his flight. And they don't really say what time we know what time the flight is, 6:15. But we don't know what time this guy left. You know what he's saying?
I felt like it was like 5.
Exactly. This guy has to make his flight in 1:15 in New York City. Yeah, and like the airport isn't closed. He was like in Times Square, and it's like not even close to the city, you know?
Can you imagine?
Yeah, I would throw up. I would cry. I'd cry. I get anxious at the airport already. Now it's like I gotta get there so fucking early. I can't handle it.
Ugh.
Yeah, exactly.
How early do you get to the airport?
I mean, depends where I'm at, but I don't know. I guess like an hour, like they say, and usually it's good.
They said like 2 hours.
Oh, well, it used to be 1 hour though. I've never, when I've been to LA, I was so anxious about that. I showed up like 4 hours early.
Really?
Cause that, yeah, LA's airport like sucks.
Yeah.
It's like super busy.
Well, it's a big airport.
It's so easy way to get there. Cause I didn't have a car. So you like get a bus at like, Union Station. Yeah. Right. It's like a whole thing, but I actually check-in was pretty quick, and I had like 3 or 4 hours to kill. But at least as long as I'm there, I feel better about it. As long as I get there, I'm like, okay.
Yeah, if I'm flying out of DCA, I feel comfortable getting there an hour before.
Yeah, that's why. I mean, that's usually where I fly out of. It's like right there.
Yeah.
But then if I'm flying back. Yeah, it's probably a little bit more than an hour, just because...
Yeah, if I'm at an unfamiliar airport, yeah. I like to get there like an hour and a half.
Yeah, but I also, I mean, I get to cut lines and stuff, so it kind of goes by a little faster, personally. But also, airports back then, like, they're not like they are now. We got no place to eat or anything. It's just people sitting... and waiting, that's all there is.
Yeah, I know, this is pre-9/11.
Yeah, dude, there's not even any checkout, nobody's taking off their shoes, like...
There were so many, plane hijackings in, like, the 70s
and 80s. My mom told me that, yeah.
Yeah.
It was, like, a common thing.
Yeah, there are so many, so... Yeah... It's like obviously 9/11 is what like took it to like be an actual thing, but like
the next
you
level.
Think they would have made people take off their shoes before then, considering how many like
or something, you know. You just go through like a metal detector, you know, like okay, he's got no bombs. So.
Yeah, I forgot to declare this big bottle of olive oil that I got taken away from me. Yeah.
Oh yeah, I got a lotion taken away. Once.
Oh.
It's my dry skin, guys. I'm tired. I am tired of that. But this past weekend, I had for some bit. It's at my French guy for Halloween. I had a cigarette. I had it actually in my jacket pocket.
Lotion?
No, it was cigarette. Oh. I had a loose cigarette in my jacket pocket, and no one ever found. I mean, it's not like I just don't think you were supposed to have like tobacco products with you.
Yeah, probably
like that. Not. But yeah, no one. It didn't get detected or anything.
On a plane?
Yeah, I had.
You can
plane.
Bring cigarettes on a plane.
They have smoking lounges in the airport.
They do. Yeah. Okay. Well. I'm saying it wasn't in a box. It was just loose in my pocket.
Sorry, you're a badass.
Yeah, yeah. Guys.
What I'm trying to say is I'm a wild, wild man.
Saying, I took out during a flight, and I was like, hey, flight attendant, you like this? Hey, you like this?
That's and funny.
The guy, John Candy, in this movie, smokes in the bed, sleep. It sounds gross.
I was looking at an Airbnb for Richmond, and I was like, why is this so cheap? And then I read... the description, and I was like, if you're not okay with smoking in the house, it'd be for you.
Gross.
And it's like this old woman who just chain smokes in the house and rents out her rooms. I was
like... just get a room in her house?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
I was like, yeah, I'm not okay with that.
Yeah, that smell just...
God, stains the walls.
Yeah, dude, my uncle smoked in his house, and then my aunt was in denial that my cousin smoked, but like in his room were just loose cigarette butts everywhere. Dude, she was like, oh yeah, he smokes. And it was like, yeah, where don't you see this is a hazard? Like, you know, he was pretty cool though. But.
That's so crazy.
Yeah, that and his friends. Would autograph his walls.
It's a green room.
Yeah, it literally was like a green room. Literally was
that's
like,
hilarious.
Yo, Big Kev here.
These kids are degenerates.
Okay, so in the future, my cousin has been in rehab several times, you know, but he's doing it now. But I was so jealous of the wall thing because my dad would be so anal about the walls. He'd be like, don't touch the wall. I gotta paint that all the time. So I saw people writing, I was like, God, this is cool.
I think I'd let my kid do that. I'd make fun of them privately, but if they wanted to do that, I'd let them.
Yeah, so he's pretty cool.
I think what I'd do actually is I would give them like a board for their friends to sign. So if we moved, they could take it with them because I wouldn't want to have a conversation about how we're painting over the walls.
Yeah,
I guess if you're smoking in the house, you're not really worried about resale value.
Yeah. Also, it was a trailer. So, you know, I think it came with a smoke smell, to be honest.
Probably.
And it came with like the hole in the wall and stuff. So
that's pretty cool.
Right.
That he had a room.
Yeah, a room. You could ride in, smoke in, punch holes in, you know. I didn't have that growing up. You know, if I punch a hole in my wall, oh, dude, I'd run away. I'd be so, my dad would be really mad.
Yeah, as you should be. Yeah. That's fucked up.
Yeah. But we lived in a house, and I think that the walls... lot stronger than the trailer.
When I lived off campus my senior year, I had a dude punch a hole in a wall.
At your place?
Yeah, my place at a party.
Oh, no.
Was he drunk or just mad?
He was drunk and mad.
Nice.
No one in my friend group from college is on speaking terms with him anymore for other reasons. Oh. But yeah, that was, I go, like, when we talk about it as a group or whatever, I'm always like, you know, I think that was the warning sign.
Yeah. Like, so did you have to get it? I mean, you just got it fixed?
I fucking like managed to like lie to the leasing office, and I sent them an email being irate that like, because we'd only lived there for a few weeks.
Oh, that it was there like when you got
that
there.
That it was there when I got it, and they sent someone to fix it. And like,
hell yeah, badass.
That's the fact that
she's the real badass.
Yeah, that's
awesome.
That's what I should do.
I sent like thing. I was like, it's unacceptable the way we've like found this place, and like blah blah blah. And I was like, I'm gonna fucking try this, and then yeah, it worked. But
that's fair.
The fact that we got our entire security deposit back from that place. I had a roommate who smoked hookah in the house down. It was fucked. Yeah.
Yeah. That's at least we had it back. That's all that.
I had this gay roommate who would snore so loudly in the room next to mine that I would walk over in the middle of the night and just grab his nose and shake it. and then go back to bed. And he would just be like,
you have sleep apnea? I mean, geez, someday. So it's like he needs a sleep apnea machine.
Anyway, yeah, like I.
Yeah. Yeah, anyway, they go on the airplane and they can't go to Chicago. It's snowed.
It's so funny to watch how inconvenient things are.
Yeah, it's basically everything.
You can't communicate with people.
So like he calls his wife, but like she only gets calls like every other day. So she doesn't know where he is. Like she can't text him.
Like, can you imagine?
Yeah, so she has, most of the time she has no idea. She hasn't heard from him in like, you know, over 24 hours.
Like, that's what the 80s, I guess, were. It's basically like waiting around for people and not knowing where anyone is.
Yeah. It's crazy to think about that.
It's crazy to think just not having like GPS in general. Like you don't know where you're going. You're just like when they're driving on the interstate, it's like, do they know like where which way to go? Like, you know, because they can't turn around and whatever.
Yeah.
So, and if you had GPS, they wouldn't be driving on the wrong side of the road also. You would have known about that.
Yeah, it's crazy. Yeah. It's crazy just how...
I don't know how people went back then, guys.
Well, yeah, if you were going to meet someone and they were, like, late and you wouldn't know where they were.
Like, how long would you wait?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or if your husband just, like, is hours late because he was stuck on the train, but, like, how are you supposed to know?
Yeah,
it's exactly. You just got used to living like that.
Yeah.
You're used to living like that.
That's this constant communication we have.
I mean, that's why they say, oh, like, no one ever knew where their kids were.
Yeah, because... Yeah. They have phones and, but you know.
Which is why missing curfew is such a big deal.
Yeah.
Back in the day.
Yeah. Some of us were like, don't worry about curfew, ma. You know?
I've got a cigarette in my pocket.
This one time, me and my friends, as a joke in high school, we I don't know if I told this story or the other part, but anyway, as a joke, we like put this condom on a dude's doorknob, and then we like waited in our car to watch the reaction. But then the dude got in his car, so we like dashed out of there and we drove away. But then we realized he was following us, so then we had to like we actually lost him. We went back to my friend's house. But then he had the license plate and the police showed up to her friend's house.
Oh no.
So anyway, we had to give him the names, we had to give us our names because we were disturbing his peace or whatever. He had like a year to like, if he wanted to, press whatever charges. But the policeman has everyone's name except mine. I did the right thing. I was like, hey, I was involved. My name is Martin Phillips.
And he's like, you're good.
All my friends were like, yeah, we thought that was stupid. We didn't know why you said, I thought I was being a bigger man. Everyone's like, that's dumb, you know? There you go. I had to tell my mom about that. And she just said she was disappointed. But I was like, well, if I'm not in trouble, it's like, okay, cool. So
there's a story like about these, this like kids in like my group in college who were like a year younger than us, they were caught like smoking weed in the dorms and they flushed the joint and then so they were fine. But then the campus police showed up and they're all like, you know, it smells like marijuana, blah, blah, blah. And then one of the kids goes, we did it. It was us. And they were fine. They flushed everything, whatever. And they were like, are you fucking kidding me? He's like, we did it.
We definitely do something like that.
Yeah. That was very like, Martin Phillips.
It was like, it's a little bit, I guess. Yeah. So, anyway. But yeah, then I got pulled over. Like a month later, and then
you're driving erratically.
I was like leaning too much to the right or something. And he was like, "Hey, did you do that?" And I was like, "Yep."
You got a record.
Yeah, I don't think it's on there anymore.
It's just unpaid parking tickets.
I have a lot of parking tickets and stuff. But anyway, that was a cool prank, guys. You know how I used to be. He's a wild guy, you know.
One thing I did want to talk about in this movie is how much longer the script was than the movie.
Yeah,
and they didn't edit it until post. So the script was like 145 pages. But the actual movie is only 93 minutes. So instead of just like having the script more condensed, they just shot a ton of footage and cut it. So there's some things where I was like, I feel like we were missing a little bit of like exposition here and there. And that made me, I was like, I feel like that's connected to the fact of like not having the condensed script off the bat and just cutting from like all the footage.
At the end, C. Martin realizes that John Kennedy's wife's been dead the whole time. But like, I don't know, it's like, I felt like it was like a forced connection. Like it was kind of more subtle that he was talking about his wife being dead, I guess.
Right. Yeah,
so I feel like that's probably why it was like that way. Because it was supposed to be longer. But I don't know, I guess they make it work, I guess.
Yeah, apparently the script was also written in like 3 days or something crazy.
Yeah, the guy who made this, John Hughes, has a lot of credits under his belt. So he writes a lot of stuff. He wrote a Christmas movie, not Thanksgiving. He wrote Home Alone. And I remember my mom used to not like us watching it because she didn't like bad parenting.
That's so funny.
She was like, how would they not know their kid wasn't there? You know what I'm saying? Like, she was like, that's awful. It's not even funny. She's like, it's not even funny. Like, they're
bad. She's like, this movie, it's a joke.
Yeah, it's not, my mom does that a lot where I'm like, well, it's a movie. It's not supposed to.
What else did your mom not let you watch?
Oh,
for she, like,
well,
reasons.
She hated stuff like The Simpsons and stuff.
Really?
Yeah, I couldn't watch
it. But it's so smart.
Yeah, but she, I don't know. She just,
was it vulgar to her?
I think it was probably some vulgar with it. Yeah. And stuff. Yeah, I probably just snuck. I had to sneak watch The Simpsons. But yeah, stuff like The Simpsons she didn't like. I think there's like other cartoons like that. I think like Red and Stimpy, I don't think she was a big fan of. Yeah, there is selective. It was mostly children's programming, I guess. Yeah.
Well, Simpsons isn't for kids.
Yeah, but it's still like cartoons, so I think that's why we're like interested in it and stuff. Yeah. So yeah. Then they're fairly strict about the film ratings, okay? Like, mm-hmm. If I wasn't 13, we are not watching this PG-13 movie. Like, R and stuff. Yeah. They were pretty strict about that.
Do you remember your first PG-13 movie?
I don't know if it might have been The Mummy. The Mummy was pretty cool, I think.
My mom wouldn't let me watch Rugrats.
Oh, I think we were allowed to, but I don't think she liked it. I think Angelica, I don't think she liked it. Angelica was pretty mean.
Yeah. My mom just didn't believe in calling children rugrats. She thought it was a derogatory term for children.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, that's it. Okay. There was more. Okay.
She wouldn't let me watch SpongeBob, not because she thought it was bad, but because she personally felt it was annoying. Dude, and she didn't want it on.
Actually,
like in the background. So she was just like, I'm just going to nip this all in the bud. You can't watch that.
Actually, I hear my sister doesn't allow her children to watch SpongeBob. And I'm very upset about that.
Yeah.
SpongeBob is pretty funny, guys.
There's some other things, but I stayed with my grandma a lot when I was little.
Okay.
And she had Nickelodeon and we didn't. And I was just going, I was going buck wild over there. I was like,
did she not have cable or?
When I was a little kid, we just had like PBS.
Yeah, you didn't have cable.
We didn't have cable. So I go over to my grandma's and I was like, fuck yeah, I'm going to grandma's.
I was like,
I'm going to do some real damage here. And my grandma would make me a glass of orange juice, and I would watch my programs. Then one day my grandma was like, your mom told me like you weren't allowed to watch this, because I was like watching Rugrats, I was watching whatever, and I was like, oh, like
really? Oh,
really?
Weird. That's weird.
I was like, that's weird.
Yeah, there was yeah. Well, my cousins had HBO, so that was cool. But
dang.
Yeah, dude, we never had HBO growing up. We never had that. And then so
it's funny how we didn't have like cable then.
Yeah. Now you have everything now.
Now my parents have fucking everything. Yeah, and they're like, let's watch this. Yeah. Let's watch that.
That is interesting. I think
they're also like younger and had little kids. It was probably like a money thing.
Yeah, but too, I guess.
Now they're flush with every streaming service.
Doing well, yeah. There was a show, a cartoon called Two Stupid Dogs. My mom didn't like that it had the word stupid in it. Because stupid's a bad word, so I couldn't watch Two Stupid Dogs. I don't know if you guys remember. But then, so we did not. I did not have a TV in my room. My parents were not about that. They were like, "Yeah, you're not gonna have a TV in your room." But then, by the time middle school, I was really pressing. You know, like, come on. So what they gave me was my dad had this TV, I guess, from his childhood, and it had an antenna, and I had
one too.
Yeah, I had knobs.
Yeah,
and I didn't have cable. I just had you get the local channel. So I would. Yeah, so because you get like 15 channels or something. So, but during this time in the early 2000s, so you didn't need cable. I had primetime television. You know, I had CBS, NBC.
That's so funny.
So, yeah, that was my first TV.
Yeah, I had one of those like little, it was like a camping TV that was black and white with the antenna.
Yeah,
It was like made for camping. Okay. And remember I would sometimes watch things like in my room on it, and I was watching Gilmore Girls, and I assumed I was in middle school, and I assumed my mom wouldn't let me watch it because it's like about like an unwed mother or whatever.
Yeah.
And she finally caught me watching Gilmore Girls, and she was like, "Oh my God, we should watch this together."
Oh, that's
like,
good. That is right. Yeah,
and then we started watching Gilmore Girls together.
Nice.
Every week. But she was like, "Oh my God, like let's watch it together."
Nice. That's fun.
And I was like, "This is shocking."
Yeah. I know, probably good. Yeah. But yeah, but then my parents had new TVs. I got the old TV, but still did not have cable. But I had a remote, so that was cool. So I think that TV is still in that room somewhere.
Really? So, do you have the same? Do you stay?
Dude, so okay, this is crazy too. My parents never did anything to my room. Because I think deep down they were worried, like, something's going to happen. He's going to move back or something. which they were kind of right during COVID. So it kind of looked like their son died or something. And they never fixed the room. But I've talked to my mom about it. Like, yeah, they get a guest room or something. But yeah, it's my room.
I mean, my childhood room looks the same.
So you stay in the same room too?
Yeah.
Okay. It's
I mean, they use it as the guest room. They just haven't like redecorated it.
Yeah. It's just, yeah.
Mine's like totally different. It's all gone. Yeah.
I moved into the house. We moved into the house when I was like in the eighth grade. So it's not like pink, you know?
Oh, yeah, yeah. I mean,
like some of my stuff is still there.
Yeah.
Just like all my childhood stuff and then like my mom's exercise bike and like.
Nice. Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, well, my sister moved out first and then she had a bigger room. So I moved into her room.
Classic.
Yeah.
Older sibling leaves for college.
She had a bigger room.
Yeah.
She's a few years older than me and the room's light blue. But then my old room, my mom did convert that into her office. So they did not keep my sister's room, to be fair, immediately after my sister graduated, she got married. So she wasn't moving. They really was hoping she wasn't going to move. If she was moving back, things were not going to go. Things were not going well for her, I guess. But
yeah.
So yeah, she, my original room is actually my mom's office, and she used to have a bed in it that I took it when I moved out, and then I got rid of it. But anyway, it's, yeah, that's the situation with that. But yeah, most things in my parents' house are pretty similar. They've always been, for the most part.
Yeah, they've definitely upgraded some stuff.
Yeah, my parents are kind of behind a lot of stuff, so they need a upgrade. They have a very old stereo system, literally probably from like 85. Like, they need that.
Yeah. No, the house. Yeah, my parents.
But you moved
house
into like we've been in that house, my parents, like since 1995. So
yeah,
they've been in there forever. So
yeah, the house is like beautiful, but like they definitely upgraded stuff. Like they upgraded the kitchen.
Yeah, and, yeah,
yeah.
Yeah, my parents. Yeah, we definitely they've changed stuff around in those what like 25 years or so. Like yeah, different tiles, kitchen, bathroom stuff. Yeah. So yeah, yeah, they definitely have done that. But for the most part, it's, you know, I don't really do much in my parents' house. There's not much to do anymore. I just kind of chill around. It's kind of boring. My parents are pretty, you know.
Oh, I do not get bored at my parents' house.
Why? Because it's dramatic.
No, I fucking love it.
Oh, okay.
It's great. You just go rest and hang out.
Oh yeah, I'm just saying.
I'm saying
nothing exciting happens. I need, you know, I need something, guys. I need, I don't know.
Oh.
I guess.
Yeah.
But yeah, I guess I could sleep in or whatnot.
It's just like, I don't know where I grew up. It's like the woods. So yeah, it's like nice.
I know
and
you
really
have
pretty
bad Wi-Fi connection.
Just a like stream. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Because when we Zoom, you're always like, not when I'm at my house.
Yeah, because it's like hard to.
Yeah.
It's perfectly fine for your phone. But,
fair.
Yeah, it's not set up for Zoom. But,
yeah, okay.
I mean, there's no one working from home there, or fair. Like they would have probably like upgraded it.
Fair.
Yeah.
But
it's mostly like there's nowhere for me to like go.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm more suburban, so there. I mean, it's like it's like a smaller suburban area, so there's.
Yeah,
which is regular stuff, but
yeah.
I don't really talk to anyone I went to school with anymore anyway, so, and no one lives there anymore anyway, so it doesn't matter.
I mean, that's kind of how it is
there,
where there are people who've moved back now,
yeah,
but no one I really kept in touch with.
Yeah, but Grant's friends with, like, all his high school friends. You guys
pretty
still
much
hang out.
That's
cool.
That's
a Charlie.
I think that's weird, dude.
That's
never
cool.
I mean, it's just people did stay here and move back.
Yeah, well,
here, so.
You know, you're outside a major metropolitan area.
Yeah, I feel like the people I knew grew up in, like, the Arlington area. It is, like, they seem to have retained more ties with their high school friends. Yeah.
It is weird. We go to, like, high school parties and stuff.
Yeah.
High school people.
That's
yeah,
so fun.
Dude, I also go to high school parties.
That's so fun.
Yeah, I'm also like, no. Dude, when we graduation, dude, there were so many graduation parties. I went to people's parties. I never even like fucking talked to at high school. I was just like, yo, '09 baby.
That's so funny.
Yeah.
That's when you graduated high school.
09?
Yeah, that was right. 09. Yeah, what? You were 2012, right?
2012.
Yeah.
I only really talked to like a couple of people I went to high school with, but it's like where I grew up, it's like, it's not a big employer or anything. People,
yeah, exactly.
People either like work in the town or they commute somewhere that's a lot further. So
yeah,
like it's not like Arlington where you can like go be there in DC or something.
Go to Clarendon and see everybody.
Yeah. Although someone who I went to high school with, actually, yeah, someone I went to high school with works at my job, like at the same work. And people are always like, oh, yeah, y'all are like friends in high school. And I'm like, oh, no, she was like a lot cooler than I was.
Yeah.
So I think we had a class together. We were not friends.
We never talked.
You know? Yeah, we never talked.
Yeah, ever see people you went to high school with, like, oh, dude, Martin. And I'm like, yo, we never like fucking talked back then. Like, okay, you do, I guess. But yeah, anyway. But yeah. It's cool. I only talked like my best friend from high school I still talk to, so
yeah, I try and keep in touch with like a few people, but
yeah, he's
and a couple of people have moved back to North Carolina.
Nice. Which is cool.
When I opened for Hannah Einbinder, a lot of people from high school reached out.
Yeah, of course. Of course. Yeah.
That was the, yeah, that was the first.
Yeah. Yeah. I remember one time, actually, a guy went to high school with showed up to a show I was hosting. And I remember my set was like, okay, it didn't go as well as I thought. And I was like, man, God, he's going to talk to people and be like, oh, dude, I saw Martin do comedy. I don't know. I don't know about it, bro. And I'm like,
Yeah, Hannah Einbinder was the first person that a lot of people who were not like fans of comedy cared about. And so I had a lot of messages from Dick people. Name. Yeah, I hadn't like, talked to you in high school. Yeah.
Like when I did Gilbert Gottfried. Like, yeah. A lot of people are like,
whoa.
Yeah, exactly. I think people I went to school with, I don't know what, I think they might think I'm doing better than I am. I don't know if they realize like my actual, how the comedy career is actually going, but whatever. I don't know. They might think I'm bigger. I don't know.
I know last year at Christmas, one of my cousins was like, oh, do you make all your money doing comedy now? And yeah. I was like, absolutely not.
Exactly. Yeah, they asked that too. And I'm like, yeah, I wish.
Or... I was like, when I filled out my taxes, I made negative dollars. Like, I made negative $100. But
yeah, do you report that?
Yeah.
I don't know what it's reported.
Well...
Hey, come on.
I also, like, I have a show I run.
Oh, fair. I don't.
So I kind of have to.
I used to have all this money. It's cool.
You can get away with it, but, like, Yeah.
You do the show thing, so it's different, but...
Well, yeah, if I didn't report the show, it makes it look like I'm making, like, $12,000 more than I am.
Damn,
a year.
Much.
Yeah, but then after you, pay everyone, pay the comics, the photographer, your sound system, like all of that, then it's like it's definitely not that. But if you have, like, in one tax year, I had like 12 sold out shows. That made me look like I was making a lot more money than like I actually did.
Fair.
So I keep receipts for everything.
That's fair.
Yeah.
So it was my dad. So he keeps receipts from like fucking gas.
I saw I had the same like receipt organizer that my grandmother had.
Yo.
I was like, oh shit.
Yeah. You also have this stuff, man. But I think I have a videograph. This has something to do with the movie, but
we're at 45, by the way.
Yeah, so I got this guy, I guess he went to my comedy show once. Shout out DJ Teddy Beats. It's a video.
Oh yeah, you sent the
yeah. So his girlfriend reached out to me and she was like, yo, you're hit out the second email. His girlfriend reached out to me and his girlfriend / manager. Oh fuck, can we not do it? Okay. His girlfriend / manager, which is the best type of girlfriend to have, who's gonna, you know,
girlfriend manager.
Anyway,
that's a classic trope, right?
Yeah, she was like, yeah, you have any shows coming up? And I told her and they couldn't make it. So then she said, oh, are you on Cameo? And I was like, no, I'm not that famous. So then she was there. Then I was like, well, I can just like make the Cameo. So this is the Cameo I made.
Is that cake?
This is DJ Teddy.
Hey, Teddy, what's going on? It's me, your favorite comedian, Martin Phillips, and I'm here. I heard it was your birthday, and yo, I'm celebrating too. I gotta tell ya, I love celebrating your birthday. I really went all out this year. I had a good time. So,
where are these desserts from?
To you, you know?
I bought them.
So, you have a good time without
matter. Parfait.
And hopefully, I get out of here. I told him, you know, because
I can get to them because that's all it is. You need to stick together. So, anyway, you know, I can't be DJ. You get DJ and I'm doing that.
I'm so upset.
I hope, I hope I survive DJ Teddy's Beats birthday myself. So, see you around. Have a good one. Bada bing.
He has t-shirts that say, I survived partying with DJ Teddy Beats.
That's super cool. Also, you should do a cameo. That was good.
You have to be like famous on cameo.
Yeah, just put it up there.
Yeah, I'm just like, who wants to do some guy, a local guy? Anyway, so that's the birthday message, DJ Teddy Beats. But you know, this movie we did, you know, it's all about guys who love their wives. You know, John Candy carries around a framed photo of his wife that he brings. Granted, she's dead, but he brings it around everywhere. And, you know, Steve Martin just wants to go home to his wife. So it's about, you know, sanctity of marriage, right, Jenny?
Yeah, he's a family man. He's been prioritizing work, you know? Yeah, and now, as he's on this road trip across America with this dude that's annoying,
he's really annoying, why
didn't I prioritize my family?
Yeah, you missed his family and
his
kids.
Why am I toiling under capitalism when like, the important thing is being home for Thanksgiving with my beautiful wife?
Exactly. She was very pretty.
She was very pretty. 80s pretty. Very 80s.
Yeah, you know, 80s pretty. So
I was like, oh, this is an 80s hot mom.
Definitely. She is. She probably has perky breasts.
Martin.
That's an 80s thing. If you didn't know. Anyhow, okay.
Mr. Phillips, everyone.
You know what I'm talking about, guys. Okay. Anyway, it's a really good movie. It's a good, fun movie. You can, you know.
I feel like there's not a lot to say about it because it is like a good movie.
Yeah,
like,
it is, you know.
It's a formula buddy comedy, but like the performances are very good. Steve Martin is very good. Like, it's not really like my cup of tea, but it's like, it's at what it sets out to do, it is excellent at.
Yeah.
And yeah, like it's very, And it's like instead, it feels, it's got that like tension throughout it.
Yeah.
And it's very like, will they, won't they, only instead of like a traditional romance, it's like the like instigators, like these outside forces. Yeah, so exactly.
Will they make it?
Yeah. It's like a road trip comedy.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. No, it's, in a lot of ways, it's kind of like, oh, like, yeah, they don't really, you don't see a lot of movies anymore that like are this. Like this, where it's like, it's, you don't need all the bells and whistles for it to be a really good movie, right?
Yeah, it's
you
very
just need,
simple.
Like, conflict and, like, true characters.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
That's- yeah.
Yeah, it's great writing. Yeah, it's very
simple. Yeah, it is. Like, it's very well written. It's very well performed. And
yeah, John Candy is a treasure, guys.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's,
R.I.P.
It's hard to find something bad to say about it because they establish, like, from the get-go what it is.
Yeah.
And then they just, like, deliver every single time.
Fair.
So.
Yeah, it's good. It's just Thanksgiving and... about dudes who love their wives.
Yeah.
They
and it's like,
at the end?
What?
They become friends at the end, is that what it is?
Yeah.
They're just like brother buddies at the
he
end.
Like, he realizes his wife's dad. It's just like, oh, come have Thanksgiving with my family.
Oh.
Yeah, it's like punch, 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 like physical comedy, like external force, whatever, and then building up emotional moment.
Yeah.
And then reconvene at the end. Like
exactly.
It hits like all of that. So,
yeah.
Yeah.
Cool.
Do you want to do the summary, Martin?
Yeah, guys. We can do that.
I'll time you.
Okay.
Go.
Okay, it's about a guy who wants to get help to his family. Then he leaves his painting kind of late. And then he gets a taxi. Some guy stole it. Then he finds a guy at the airport in a delayed flight. They're on the same flight. And then it gets rerouted. And then it gets stuck at an airport. And then they can't fly, so they like take a bus. And then they can't do a bus anymore. So then they rent a car. And then a lot of crazy and wacky stuff happens that like involves like car being blown up and whatever. And then it takes forever. They end up getting in the back of a truck to make it to the Chicago Metro. And then as Steve Carter leaves, he's like, oh, wait. Oh, dude, I think his wife's there. He's not going anywhere. So he brings his new friend in Thanksgiving, and they have a great time together with his hot wife.
Nice.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, to play this out, we got the new Taylor, guys. But it's been an anti-hero. I think it's kind of like how John Candy was. Will is dumb in the bottle.
Yeah, we're crushing the champagne.
Yeah, he's three of us.
So. That was nice, Martin. Thanks for bringing that.
Yeah, it was, oh, wow, I had to have it.
Right.
Yeah, but no. Yes, Martin.
Oh, yeah.
That was a good thing. That was a nice surprise.
You're welcome, everybody.
Yes,
anyway. Thanks for listening. Happy.
Happy Thanksgiving, Ron Bros. Cool. Happy Friendsgiving.
That too.
Boys.
Okay. We're gonna take a picture of the poster.
Yeah, I need